When I got that infamous call on August 29th from Eddie McFadden saying that we now had water in at least 5 of our buildings, we knew that it was going to be bad. Initial estimates were that probably wouldn't take that long, maybe a semester, more than maybe a semester and a half to get back together until we started the walkthrough and our Blackman Mooring specialist saw the extent of the damage and all the expensive equipment and areas that were not only damaged by floodwaters but by raw sewage from the City of Houston wastewater treatment plant. Contents being backed up and coming through our floor drains. That was the flood on the 29th and our first walkthrough on the 30th. The first change in morale I actually saw this fall when we had 41 classrooms available on campus. That includes the 10 modulars that were brought in. And think about all last year, barely any students on campus. We had had 9 classrooms. We created 6 basically in the student conference center and in our music rooms. So really a small population of students. We couldn't offer all the core courses here, and many were online and dispersed throughout our other sites, including our sister colleges. So this fall to have 41 classrooms, and out of our 12,740 fall students, about 4,500 are physically on this campus taking classes, and they're excited. It's fun to see them excited to be back at their campus. By December the 7th, we should have all of our hardwired specialty equipment that's mostly in the healthcare come in, be installed, whether it's by the vendor, the contractors, or by us. And then a couple days later, by December the 10th, we will have the furniture arrive for both the fitness center and the classroom building B. And those are one-story facilities, and they're the furthest along, so those will be set up first. And then a week later, because we also depend on not only all the flooring being done, finishing somewhat being done, but also on the life safety alarm systems, fire alarm systems, all being operational and blessed by the City of Houston. So the healthcare building, the classroom building A, those have the most extensive number of classrooms and specialty equipment in them. All of that will be delivered around December the 17th. And we expect many more to kind of come in and trickle in by December the 21st. Our student services are reporting over and over again in the phone calls they're making to students who aren't here this semester, or maybe who weren't here in the spring as well, tell us that they definitely will be here this spring. They've been able to get their homes back, are far enough along that they feel comfortable with resuming their educational goals in the spring. I think that we will be back better than ever. And for the most part, we'll look like a brand new, at least rejuvenated, but new community college. We're ready for new beginnings. So I think that's it. We're all ready for new beginnings.